By the way, that was a third place winner in the last Oktoberfest song. It was slightly modified, but basically it was. I'm Mark Roth. I like Russ and like Pam. I one day will be past president of our sanitarium. An interesting thought that occurred to me that I wasn't going to talk about when Merrily was talking was, wouldn't it be funny if the laws were written that I could assault you and it would be okay as long as I didn't harm you more than 15%? Wouldn't that be great?
Only if I could assault back.
I think about that. I mean, really talking about, you know, we're allowed to harm the environment only so much. Am I allowed to harm you only so much? Public interest. So section 373.223 of the Florida statutes does the three-point test, the three-prong test. And the public interest appears twice in the three-prong test narrative, in part one and in part three. Part three is the public interest item. And that's about it. It's not defined anywhere else. That's kind of interesting, because then what makes up the public interest? I know that Seven Springs permit is not on the agenda today. It is my hope and prayer that it will never be on the agenda. But if it is, we want to make sure that when it gets there, you know what the public interest is. And if you can't see it here today, you're not looking. This is the public interest. I don't know if this has ever happened to you, or somebody you know, go to the doctor, you feel like hell, you look like hell. Doc, what's wrong? The doctor, a scientist, he takes all the tests. He does the blood tests, he does all the tests. And so everything checks out, you're absolutely fine. You can't find anything wrong. Well, I believe your scientists are great. Your scientists are the best in the state, I feel. But something's wrong with the river. The river is sick. It looks like hell. It doesn't feel good. And so something's wrong. And so something needs to stop. At some point along the line, we're going to have to stop giving away water to figure out really what's wrong, regardless of how the science can be done. We have a problem here, and you've heard about it from so many other people. In keeping short, I just want to end with a request. I want you to consider finding a legal way to do this. The renewal application, well, the Seven Springs permit was filed on March 13th of 2019. Your staff recently issued a request for additional information. I commend staff for that request for additional information. It's an unprecedented, not unprecedented, maybe, but very rare third request. They're really trying to get the science worked out. And I appreciated that. And their response date is February 25th. March 13th to February 25th. So we have almost a year that this renewal application is in process. And during this year, the permit, which expired in June, continues to be grandfathered in. The law says that they can continue to pump. And I don't know that there's a way to do this, but I'm concerned that after the fourth and fifth requests for additional information, we could be 2 years into this pumping, and by then, I'm afraid that Nestle, and I wasn't going to say the N-word today, I'm afraid that Nestle is going to have their bulk transfer stations finished, and they'll be pulling the full 1.152 that maybe we've never pulled before. And I would really like to see if the board can, at least during this grandfather period, either stop the pumping because of the time that's gone on, or at least reduce it to the average, half of the average.